poor person that's struggling a little bit with their lower back or sciatica, I came to yoga because of a bad back. So I can tell you that one of the greatest poses known to man, I call it the holy pose, is Supta Baddha Konasana. And we are just going to start here because it's a great way to catch the breath. And you can see I took a bolster lengthwise. I put a blanket at the top to create a little connection so that when I come on down, sorry y'all, it's freezing in here, so excuse my socks. I ran into a heat problem this morning. So you can see I'm just laying over my bolster, and the reason we have the blanket is to create that connection between the shoulders and the ears. So I slide that blanket down so it's really right to the shoulders. Let's take the soles of the feet together. And I think it's always a good idea, we're not staying here for a long time, just a good time, but if you have a couple of blocks or some pillows or even a blanket, but blocks are what I'm using. If you have no blocks, you can also take a blanket, which is what I do at home. And you can see I'm just taking the blanket underneath and like so. Pretty cool, eh? Yeah, give that a shot, lovely Linda. And this supports in both underneath the shin, underneath the outsides of the outer thighs, and we're gently pressing the outer feet together. And let's start to discover what the breath means in this pose, Supta Baddha Konasana. Slow spoon inhale, and start to feel the sides of the arm and chest lifting through the back. Inhale. Slow, smooth, exhale. Follow all the way through that exhale. See if you can feel the breath come right down into the lower belly area and pass right out through the sit bones. So completing the exhale, making that exhale the same length as the inhale. Slow and smooth. So you'll notice when you start to focus on the breath, how the mind will start to jump into this process. So it takes a few minutes to start to settle into the breath. So be a little patient with yourself and start to just let those thoughts go and allow the breath to start to become the most important thing. Fill the room with the breath. Start to create some energy inside and out through the breath, slow and smooth. So as you inhale, feeling the armpit chest, the front center chest, and the back body lifting through the inhale. Allow the exhale to create an even further lift higher up through the collarbone. So as you follow through the exhale, allowing the breath to come down into the lower belly area, lift through the collarbone area, pressing through the outside of the feet. You can see I gently lifted my buttocks and took it a little closer to the heels to release that lower back. Anytime the lower back is bothering you, you can either come down a little lower, so reduce the height, maybe roll the blanket up, lay over the blanket lengthwise, or just simply lift your knees and bring the soles of the feet sensation of lifting up. So we're not moving the legs, we're gently trying to create that sense of pulling or lifting the kneecaps up, maybe even feeling the upper thighs lifting. And at the same time, there's a second action as we create length along the top of the thighs, out through the kneecaps. So from the hip along the top of the thigh, as the thigh gets longer and longer, glutes away from the lower ribs to create that space through the front of the body. All through the breath. Soften the arms now, just release your forearms down. Let's inhale as we lift the knees out through center. And exhale as you gently place your feet to the floor. And let's roll over to the right. So if you have a block, then just move your block off to the side. And we're going to make our way up now.
Taking that left thigh back, dropping that right hip down.
chest on top of the thigh. And bring your right knee, so it's stacking on top of that right ankle. Drop that right hip down. That's it. Drop your chest a little further. And you can see, I'm trying to look slightly forward and draw the shoulders down away from the ears. So we're dropping the chest, but we're lengthening the spine. That's it. Try to drop the chest, lift the left kneecap, drop the right hip. Good. And then slowly come up. And drop the right foot down to meet the left. Good. And now, let's turn to the side. So this is a lateral stretch. Let's take the right foot like so. This is one of my favorite stretches in the morning. And again, let's focus on lifting that left kneecap to start. So the standing leg. Lift that left kneecap. Good. Lift the left kneecap. So you can feel how to lift the kneecap. We're lifting up and out of the ligaments and joints. You can feel the body. Intelligize and get longer and longer. So lift that left kneecap and drop that right sit bone down towards that inner left knee. See if you can reach through that right heel. And all we're doing is sliding the right hand down and reaching the left arm up and over. Oh my lord, this sunshine is to die for. So drop that right sit bone down, lift that right kneecap, lift that upper thigh, and see if you can make that right leg longer and longer. Lifting that left kneecap, dropping that right sit bone down towards the inner left knee. So that outer right buttocks cheek is drawing down in and under. So rotate around the head of this right femoral. So it takes a little time. Use the breath to create that space inside the body. Try to pause in between each breath, allowing the softness to come into the mix. Make that right leg longer and longer. Drop your shoulders a little further down now. Lift through the arm to chest, and as you lift your left kneecap and your left thigh, draw that left thigh back. So you feel the outer buttocks cheeks draw in. Good. And then slowly come up. Probably all been doing a little bit of sitting. So we're looking to intelligize the whole body here. Let's take that left leg. And again, take a look at your right foot and make sure. And if this is too much, as I said, just turn to the side and you've got the wall, right? You need the wall. And some days, you need the wall. Okay, cool. So look at that right foot and make sure that it's hanging straight forward. And let's find that standing leg. So lift the right kneecap. Feel that. Feel how the leg starts to get firm. It is so important to find the standing leg. So lift that right kneecap. See if you can feel the upper thigh lift. That's it. Continue lifting through that right knee. Making that right leg stronger and stronger. Feel that outer right buttocks cheek draw in. And let's look at the left leg now. And lift the left kneecap up. Lift your left kneecap. So hopefully we didn't let the right kneecap drop as we start to lift the left kneecap, but you never know. You can see I'm stroking both legs. giving them a little love as they seem to respond much better to a little love. Lift the upper thigh now. Reach through that left heel. So start to make that left leg longer and longer. Drop that left sit bone down towards that inner right knee. So drop it down. So you want to create that sense of drawing the outer buttocks cheeks in, lengthening that left leg. That's it. And let's reach the arms up. And let's lengthen the thumbs. So if one side more difficult than the other, you have to accommodate. Maybe you're staying longer on that side. Maybe you need to be a little more patient on that side. So we're lifting that right kneecap to create that length through the body as we pop and lift up and out of the limbs and joints. Lift the left kneecap. Drop that left sit bone down. So drop that left hip down. So we don't want to take such a height underneath that left leg that we start to lift the hip. We want that left hip dropping down. We feel that sense of the inner thighs squeezing together. Let's change the length of the thumbs. So if you can open through your armpit chest. So we need that standing leg to create that opening. How are you doing there, lovely Linda?
Swaying,
yes. Exactly. So lift both kneecaps. See what happens when you lift the kneecaps.
Good job.
Good job, everybody. And then let's take the arms down. Left knee, and just place the left foot on the chair so the knee is right on top of the ankle. Let's lift that right kneecap, so use that standing leg like crazy. So the more you lift that kneecap and upper thigh, rotate around the head of that right femur bone, the stronger that right leg gets. And then hinging, let's fold forward, try to keep your spine long. Drop your chest on top of the left thigh. So try to have the gaze slightly forward, shoulders down, away from the earth. Very nice. Linda, you are so flexible. It is awesome. Just awesome. So lift the left kneecap and see if you can take that left sit bone down towards that right knee. Dropping that left hip still. Feel the arms and chest, lift and lengthen. Feel the sides are going to get long. Shoulders down away from the ears. Try to find that exhale as you lift through the collarbone area. So there's even more length here. Drop your chest on top of the back. Lift your kneecaps. Lift your kneecaps. Shoulders down away from the ears. Ridiculously happy. Ali, I think you're
good. I think so too.
Yeah, I do.
You're smashing my hair.
Female bonding. Yeah. The girls love cooling. Good job, everybody. So drop that chest. Drop that left sit bone. So keep that outer left buttocks cheek drawing in and under. That left hip stick out. So if you need it higher, like so, you could use that. Just give that a shot. Good. And then slowly come up. Step the left foot down.
And let's turn to the side. Take your left leg to the chair, and again, let's focus on the standing leg for a moment. Lift through that right kneecap. find the standing leg. Lift that right kneecap, lift that upper thigh. This helps to draw that right thigh back, and you can participate in the effort as you draw that outer right buttocks cheek in. So feel that rotation around the head of that right femur bone as you draw that outer right buttocks cheek in, right thigh back. So the standing leg is fully alive. Let's look at the left leg now. So lift the left kneecap and the left thigh. Lift that left kneecap and left thigh. And let's make that left leg long. So reach through the left heel. Reach through the left heel. That's it. And at the same time, lift the left kneecap. Reach through the left heel. So make that left leg long. Draw that outer left buttocks cheek in. And let's start to reach the right arm up now. Up, up, up. Right. And then over towards that left leg. That's it. So try not to look at that left leg. See if you can look towards the right underarm. And think about drawing the right leg back to create that opening through the right side body. That left sits bone is drawing towards the inner right knee, and that right kneecap is lifting. And the rest just comes through the breath. Slow and smooth. Breathe deeply, everybody. Full body breaths. Breathe deeply. Pause if you can in between each breath. See how that transforms the journey. Very nice. All right, come on up. And let's come out here. And we are going to take, so if you had a sling, we would use a sling, but for the sake of those who don't have a sling, let's just do what I call either a leg stretch or a chair stretch. So if you could manage the chair, by all means, you can take that 90-degree stretch like so, but I'm a lot closer to the ground because I'm shorter. So if you wanted to take a leg stretch, that would be also good here. So this is an example of a leg stretch. And again, we're just taking the feet hip width apart. And let's look at the feet to start. So we want those feet to be parallel, because we want to look at the internal rotation that starts to happen up near the very top inner thighs. So we don't want to roll the knees in. We want the rotation from the inner thighs, and we want the action of the feet. So see if you can press actively down through the outsides of your feet, and that's make those toe knuckles wide. So spread your toe knuckles. And let's press through the outsides of the feet. Stamp down through those outer feet. Lift your kneecaps, lift your upper thighs. And we're spreading through the backs of those thighs. So the sit bones are getting wider and wider. And we're drawing the hip bones together. So lift your kneecaps. Very nice. And this makes for a nice long spinal stretch as we extend the spine from the pelvis. Good job. You can pull your hips back, lift through your kneecaps, press through those outer heels like mats. Stomp through your upper heels. And then slowly start to come up and out. And if you need to take a break, do so. Moving right along. I think what we're going to do next is bolster and do Baddha Konasana seated. So bring a bolster right to the wall. And I'm having my strap here, but I just potential of having to demonstrate something. But for the time being, we are bringing the soles of the feet together into the happy pose, Baddha Konasana, and we want the sacrum to the wall. Yes, we do. And if you need something underneath your happy feet, no?
I need more of my happy mom.
Yes. So get that happy sacrum. So that's that bowl right here. See if you can get it pressing right to the wall. That is pretty important. Right. And then let's get the shoulder blades to the wall. As we press the sacrum to the wall, shoulder blades to the wall. So everybody, press your sacrum to the wall. Press the sacrum to the wall. And let's start to again use the breath to lift that happy armpit chest, creating some length through the sides of the body. And slowly. Pausing if you can in between each breath. Slow, smooth inhale. Slow, smooth exhale. So we continue to lift through the sides of the spine, through the collarbone area on the exhale. And pressing actively through the outsides of the feet. In those first few moments, we're just giving our body a little moment or two to become accustomed to this happy pose. But see if you can start to feel a sense of rolling those thighs out. So we're rolling these inner thighs out if we can, pressing through the sacrum. Now see if you can press the right side of the sacrum into the wall, please. Shoulders to the wall. And let's press the left side of the sacrum to the wall. Shoulders to the wall. Rolling out, pressing through the outsides of the feet. You can spread those toes wide. See if you can drop your knees down. So when you try to drop your knees down, don't look like this. Yes, yeah, baby. Let's drop those babies down. Woo! Press your happy sacrum, right side, left side. Shoulders to the wall, inner thighs out. So we could spend a long time here, right? We really could. And the longer you spend here, the better. See if you can lift. So the benefit of having the wall is that we're not collapsing, right? And the benefit of having the happy ropes is that we can walk our hands up and start to feel that length through the sides of the body. Press your sacrum to the wall. Press your shoulders to the wall, feet together, especially those happy outer feet. When I first got here, someone said to me, yours is hours and hours of entertainment. Yep. She's going to wait for the shoe to come on the chair. Rest your sacrum. So see if you can notice the difference between the right side and the left side of your sacrum. So this takes a little while, doesn't it? But you can start to feel the slow drip of transformation. You now feel it's changing from when you first arrived in the pose. And as much as we'd like to take credit for it, really it comes just from it being a happening through the breath. So breathe, everybody, deep breaths. Give yourself permission to enjoy your breath. See if you can create some length for those thighs now. So drop those knees down. Look at that. Press your sacrum to the wall. Notice if there's a difference between the right side of the sacrum and the left. So I think that if your right side, your right hip is tighter, it's harder to find that right side of the sacrum. Is it not to the wall? We want that action to ignite down there. Yes. Yes. That's it. Breathe deeply, full body breaths. So at some point, we sort of say, okay, I'm having enough. We're probably not there yet. Are we there?
No, no. I think I should have stayed here for a day.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear it. So glad to hear it. So press those outer heels. Feel your outer heels. Drop your knees down. Good job, ladies and gentlemen. Press those outer heels. Press the sacrum to the wall.
Yes, do one, Linda. So the more we lift
concave deep. Otherwise, we sit higher. And we're lifting the kneecaps to try to break the strap. Now try to break the strap.
That's it.
And so we don't want this. We want length also through the insides of the legs. And we want that internal rotation to happen. That's why the feet are parallel. So we want not the knees rolling in, the inner thighs, the very top, rolling in. And we want those feet active. So that's what creates the internal rotation, not the knees. The knees are neutral, the kneecaps are lifting. So if you notice your knees are rolling in, then adjust your legs. And let's again, let's reach the arms up. So break the strap with your feet. That's it. Make those legs long, ladies. So intelligize those legs. Reach through your heels. Make those outer heels so firm. You can feel the legs get longer through those outer heels. Lift your kneecaps, lift your upper thighs. Looking ridiculously happy. So we're spreading through the backs of the thighs. So we're untucking, and if we press the sacrum to the wall, we're tucking. But we're focusing just on making those legs longer and longer, feeling the size of the body get longer and longer. And when your goose is cooked, let's remove the strap and a simple stretch. So take your hands underneath the leg to lift the leg and just bend that right leg. And let's start to walk the hands forward. So you can see I'm trying to maintain that spinal lift, that spinal extension. Shoulders away from the air. See if you can squeeze your inner shoulders together in the back. As you lift through your open chest. Lifting that left kneecap, lift that upper thigh. Yes. Very nice. Try to flex your foot more. That a girl. And spread those toes. So I'm giving all these little cues, but that doesn't mean that I can actively create that visible difference either. But just creating an impression in the mind is the starting place. Believe me. And I am completely laser focused on trying to widen my toes. And if I can widen the fourth toe away from the fifth toe, you might even feel more feedback in your upper body.
When you get to join the circus.
That's right, and you get to join the circus. You can widen that fourth toe away from the fifth toe, you get to join the circus. Okay, so just allow yourself the indulgence of stretching forward, stretch your arms, that's it, or using your blocks, very clever, whatever it takes, whatever turns you on at this stage. We're just stretching. We're trying to create some opening to the body. Stretch is a very innocuous word. It sounds like it's easy peasy. Dr. Ross said if you stretch 5 minutes a day, you'll extend your life by decades. And the longer you linger, the more you can feel the awakening. And at some point, the body has had enough awakening. He wants to go out.
There's awakening.
Severe pain, try to draw a boundary around that pain. well said today. So again, try to look that brain again. Bring that up the thighs, so apologize and make that right leg long. And then let's start to begin, shrug the hips. We don't want to use the upper spine. That's it. And of course, if you want to use the strap, by all means, use the strap. We're just going for some simple stretching. We're really actually going for pain relief. Anybody that has a lower back pain will hopefully feel a little better after doing some of these ideas. These are just thoughts.
Thank you.
drop your knees down. Good job, everybody. And let's come up. You can either remove the strap if you have the strap. Good. So let me just give you a hint. If you were using the chair, you don't want to have the chair away from the wall because you want to be able to push actively into the chair. And now I can really participate by pushing and sticking my buttocks out. So that's a good stretch from the hips to the underarms. That's it. Good. Journey those toes in so the outsides of the feet are parallel. Pressing through those outer heels. Lift your kneecaps. Feel your inner thighs at the very top rolling in back. Okay, so that's just to help create a little more stability through that chair, is to have the chair against the wall. Good job, you guys. Very nicely done. Very nicely done. So then just stay there. I want you to just press your hands here, like so, against the arms of the chair. So you can really press that girl. So you're pressing that girl, feet wide. So evenly feet wide. That's it. Now press. Don't let go of that chair. That girl. Now lift your kneecaps. That's it. Lift those thighs. Lift those toes. Good. That's it. Good girl. Push into the chair. Drop your chest. Lift your kneecaps. Press those outer heels down, down, down. Good girl. Good job. Good. That's it. Drop your chest. More time, try to lift those kneecaps and upper thighs.
It hurts when I arch through it again.
Okay, then slowly come on up. Good job, though. That was great.
I am being talking from old age.
And then if you need to have a seat, then take a seat. Okay, good. So, now we are going to come down to the floor and do a little back work. Our favorite. So I'm just moving my mat slightly away. So we see this all the time. We really cannot do enough of this. Let me just move things off to the side here. And let's come on down. And bring your hips to the floor. And let's see if you can do your best to find your elbows so they're underneath your shoulders. And my forearms are parallel. And most of us have a tendency to bring our wrists inside of the elbows. So see if you can take your wrists so that they are right in line with the elbows. So sweeping, lovely girlfriend of mine, bring your elbows so they're underneath the shoulders, even further forward. Elbows even further forward. There we go. Now bring your elbows in so they're underneath your shoulders. So this is no easy pose, right?
It feels good though.
Yes, my teacher calls this an advanced pose. So you see how we're kind of this? So we're going to do some shoulder push-ups. So see if you can press into your elbows and draw your shoulders back and squeeze your inner shoulder blades together. Good. Press into the elbows, shoulder blades together. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. So that's just the upper body. See if you can bring your feet together now and press to the tops of the feet and lift your kneecaps. So pull up through that right kneecap. Pull through the right kneecap and see if you can press through the top of that right foot. Now lift your left kneecap. Lift your left kneecap. Atta girl. Look forward. Look at me. Bring your elbows further forward, Linda. Atta girl. So I don't mean out like this. I mean forward. And then slightly wider so that they're underneath your shoulders. And then bring your forearms to the parallel. Okay. Let me come over there. Oh. Well, I know for pressure, knees are down parallel. Now spread your fingers wide and press down through your inner wrist. That's it. Now see if you can press your breath. That's it. Very nice.
Very cold.
Good job. Press through the tops of the feet, lift both kneecaps. Alrighty. Let's bring that right forearm so it's parallel to the front of the mat. And let's bend the left leg and take the left foot. Underneath the feet. So your knees are there. upstairs. Hopefully, they'll make it long back down again and see how we go.
That's it. I feel like we're in construction.
There we go. Good job. So, nice. So see if you can drop your buttocks down. Not a problem.
I could have before.
Well, I saw too much space. No, my dear. You still need that bolster, that second bolster.
Really?
Yes, you can see right there. And bring it right in. Thank you. Right in, that a girl.
Yes. Yes. Thank you. Now start to relax. Good.
Because we're releasing the spine. That was a lot of work. Let's lift the head and bring the right cheek to the bolster. And completely surrender your weight to the bolster. So if the body is like this, there's no surrender happening. And there's no release. So we need to build up and create more height. So that the whole body is completely like this and supported from the bolster. We're only here for a moment or two.
No, I'm just checking you to see what I'm doing right or wrong.
Okay, there's no such thing as right or wrong. Okay, so let's slowly come up. Let's assume. So if you need
to
Sweeping the knees. So, you know, if you didn't need to take that break because your lower back was fine, then you could bypass that, but that's just a way of releasing your spine. And then let's all come back and we are going to resume that happy back work. So come on.
I like it here. Come
on down with me. And again, let's bring the forehead to the floor. So if you needed to bring a blanket underneath your forehead, you could. Let's bring the hands to start down by the waist. Press through the top so you can see this. Lift the kneecaps up. So feel those outer buttocks, cheeks start to rotate. In. Let's lift the right leg again. Try to make that right leg long. Longer and longer. Right from behind that right buttocks cheek. And then let's slide the left arm all the way up and overhead if you can. And let's lift the head, looking straight down. Let's lift the left arm. And see if you can lengthen that left arm now from the bottom of that left shoulder blade. So make that left arm get longer and longer. Try to take all of the bend out of that left elbow. Do the work, create that length from the bottom of that left shoulder blade. Create that length through the right leg.
Are we doing right leg, left arm?
Yes, we are, ma'am. Right leg, left arm. Breathe deeply with your hand, full body breath. And let's take the left arm back down. Release the right leg. And lift the left leg now. Make that left leg longer and longer. Do so from behind this left buttocks cheek. And then slide the right arm overhead. And looking straight down, let's lift the head, lift the right arm. Woo, this is hard. Breathe deeply, everybody. Full body breaths. Breathe. Full body breaths. Feel the breath come into the lower belly area. So again, at any time you need to take a break.
Breathe.
table position. Shoulders down, away from the ears. Stick your buttocks out. Stick your buttocks out. Knees a little wider, lovely. That's it. Spread your hands wide. Shoulders down, away from the ears. So try to get the shoulders down. It's not easy, right? Mine live up here. Drag them down. See if you can squeeze those shoulders down. Sticking your buttocks. Create that widening through the backs of the thighs. So try to create more and more space there. Lift your belly. And now let's top the tailbone. Roll it one vertebrae at a time. Release your head down. And let's lift the belly. Lift the belly up and in. Breathe deeply. Lift your belly. Allow the breath to move freely through the body. Let's slowly release. Take your sits bone back up towards the sky, rolling one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders down. Pause. Look up. And let's start to slowly move through the spinal waves to the rhythm of our own breath here. Try to pause at the end of each spinal wave, because that's really where the fruit of your labor is. Try to pause in between each breath, in between each spinal wave.
Yes, but on the other hand, I like to see that.
Reach and right. lateral muscles really get a little sluggish. And I probably have done this pose in almost every class the last 20 years for a reason, because you don't get enough of this lateral movement. And we're trying to create space on the right side of the spine, leading to the underarm. Lift your right kneecap. Now lift your left kneecap. Yes. Lift your kneecaps.
Thank you.
bottom of the bolster on the left thighs. At a 90-degree angle. Let's come on over. Take your left hand and your left cheek to start. So the left hand drags that left sit bone away, creating length and tucking that left sit bone in under. If you can go a little further and lift your head and bring your right cheek to the bolster, please feel free, but if you start to snorkel the bolster, then you might feel free to go back to the left cheek. So just do whatever suits. Try to let the breath lift the arm and chest on the inhale so you start to feel the length through the spine. And use your exhale to release and let go of all that tension. Try to pause between each breath.
Good job. And then
slowly start to come out. And now we can take one of two poses, all right? We can either go like so, Warrior Buster, or legs up. So I'm giving you your option today. Here it is. Either we take this pose, and this can feel pretty good if you need a back stretch. So just stay with me here. You might decide that you like this one. So this is your option. Do this. Woo! Here we go. So I sort of sat on the end of the bolster, and I'm just looking for this nice stretch, right? This feels pretty good. Or, yes, you got it. So you sit right down here. You got it. Scooch down a little more. Scooch down a little more. You want to fly back the way I did. And then legs so. That's a little better. That was a more graceful entrance.
And then you let the legs fall.
Pardon me?
Do you let the legs just hang out?
Well, you know, you can energize the legs or just let the legs hang out. But this is quite a stretch, isn't it?
Probably we should be doing daily for about 20 minutes.
value to the central nervous system, and all fluids are reversed.